Good morning, children. In the previous video, we had started with probability, the 15th chapter. Am I right? A simple chapter. You have already come across it in 9th standard, I told you. So, you must be well acknowledged. You will be knowing about this particular chapter very well. And hence, we went a little bit faster in the previous video. Now, the remaining part of the exercise we'll take up and we'll try to finish it today itself. 19th question onwards, let us start, children. 19th question says, a child has a die whose six faces are in the form of letters. Normally, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the die, but this time it is having letters. Okay? A, B, C, D, E, A. Like that it is written. Now, means instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, it has these letters are stuck onto the die. A die is thrown once. What is the probability of getting A as well as D? Now, A how many times are there? 2 times. Out of how many? 6. So, here you will work out like this. The probability, 19 sum, the probability, you call it as P of A. So, the occurrence of A will be 2 times out of total 6 times, that comes to 1/3. And for D, okay, probability of occurrence of D, you may call it as a P of event B. Now D you will find that in the list is only once. So it is going to be 1 upon 6. Is that point clear? Very simple sum it is. Next, suppose you drop a die at random on a rectangular region as shown in the figure. This is a rectangular region and you are supposed to drop a die in this region. Okay. What is the probability that it will land inside the circle of diameter 1? The dimension of the rectangle is given to you 3 into 2. That means this full rectangle is of the area of 6 meters square. In that, you are having a 1 meter diameter circle inside. So, you should know this area. Which means the chances of the die falling in this circular region is how much when you are going to drop it at random in the rectangle. So, for that, you should know the area of the circle. Okay. So 20th sum. You first should know the area of the circle. Area of the circle is given by pi r square. That will be equal to pi. And then what is given to you? 1 meter is the diameter. So 1 by 2 square comes to how much? Pi by 4 meter square will be the area. Am I correct? Because 1 meter is the diameter. So half meter will be the radius. So pi r square is area of the circle. Okay, this is a symbol of the circle. One round you put with a dot and you write LE. It stands for circle. Clear or not? So, area of the circle is pi r square. This much is the area of the circle. Now, area of the rectangular plot. The rectangular plot's area is how much given to you? L into B. 3 into 2. Okay, 3 into 2 will give me 6 meters square. So, now you want to find the probability that the die will fall in that given region. So, if you want to find the probability, it will be equal to the area of the square divided by the area of the rectangle. Now, this is a fraction in the numerator. So, the 4 will be in the denominator and 6 will also be in the denominator. So, finally, you will get pi upon 24. This is the probability. Understood or not? If the fraction would have been in the denominator, then it would have been inverse. But this is a fraction of the numerator. So, pi and 4 and 6 will be multiplied. So, 24. Next sum. Refer to example 13.1. Complete the following table. 13.1 is what you know? In 13.1 example, I'll just turn the page and show it to you. You had this one. This is 13th example. Correct? In 13th example, we had this particular table prepared. This table you have to keep in mind. And then you have to fill up the table which is given in that exercise. What is it? Sum of the die. Sum on the die. Sum should be 2, sum should be 3, sum should be 4. Clear? Which sum are we talking about? Sum of the die is 2 means which one? See again if you go back to that. Only in this case 1 plus 1 is 2. You don't get sum equal to 2 in any other cases. So, total only one condition out of 36 conditions. Did you understand that? So, sum on the dice, both the dice together, sum is 2. That is coming only in this one case out of 36 possibilities. So, 1 by 36. That is already printed and given to you. So, now sum should be 3. When is sum 3 possible? सी 2 + 1 = 3 एंड 2 + 1 = 3। इसके अलावा कहीं पर भी आपको 3 नहीं मिलेगा। सो टोटल 2 पॉसिबिलिटीज आउट ऑफ हाउ मच 36। द नेक्स्ट वन इज 4। सो 4 इफ यू वांट, व्हेन इज 4 पॉसिबल? 3 + 1 = 4, 2 + 2 = 4, 3 + 1 = 4। इसके अलावा कहीं पर भी आपको 4 नहीं नजर आएगा। सो इट विल बी 3/36। सो यू विल कंप्लीट द टेबल लाइक दैट। ओके, 1/36, 2/36, 3/36, ओके, 5, सम शुड बी 5। इन विच केसेस डू यू गेट द सम 5? लुक ओवर हियर अगेन, 2 + 3 = 5, 1 + 4 = 5, 3 + 2 = 5, 4 + 1 = 5। सो ऑल दीज नंबर्स यू विल गेट 5। क्लियर ऑर नॉट? देन 6 दे आर सेइंग, 6 मीन्स 5 + 1, 2 + 4, 3 + 3, 4 + 2, 5 + 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 केसेस। Understood? Here it was 4 cases. Okay? So, did you understand what I am trying to say? So, 1/6, 2/6, 3/6, 4/6, 5/6. Clear? Here it is not by 6, 36, sorry. 2/36, 3/36, 4/36, 5/36. 7. When will you get the 7? Sum 7? Sum 7 you will get 6 + 1, 2 + 5, 3 + 4, 4 + 3, 5 + 2, 6 + 1. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cases you will get 7 total. Clear? Uske baad 8 how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times only. Isn't it? See, 7 you are going to get 6 times. So 6/36 will be 1/. Now 8 you are going to get 5 times. Understood? Just now we counted. And then keep on. So you will find that from here it is increasing, then it keeps on decreasing. Because 12 only one, 6 will give you 12. Understood how to fill up this table? Okay. Now the second question, no need to do it because it's already worked out in the first one. So that is how this 22nd one, first part is to be computed. Clear? Now 23rd. A game consisting of tossing a 1 rupee coin 3 times and noting its outcome each time. So you are going to toss the coin, 1 rupee coin, 3 times you are going to toss. When you toss a coin 3 times, it's like saying 1 coin you toss 3 times or 3 coin you toss 1 times. Both the result will be the same. Okay. So 1, if you are tossing 3 times, what will be the possibility first of all? That possibility you will have to write down first. Okay. So possibility over here is, if you are going to toss the coin, your chance is 3 times you are going to toss. So you will get all the 3 times head. You might get head, head, tail. You might get head, tail, head. You might get tail, head, head. You might get tail, tail, head. Head, tail, tail. Tail, head, tail. Okay. And finally, all the 3 tails. Means 8 possibilities are there. Did you understand? 3 baar aap coin uchhal rahe ho. Ho sakta hai ki 3 baar aapko head mile. When you are tossing it 3 times, you might get 2 times head and 1 time tail. Next possibility is you might get first time head, second time tail and third time head. Did you understand that? So when you say you are tossing 1 coin 3 times or 3 coin 1 time, this will be the possibility. 8 possibilities are there. Now come back to the question. What is the question telling you? A game consists of tossing a coin 3 times and noting its outcome. That outcome you already noted. Hanif wins if all the tosses give the same result. That means if he is having 3 heads or 3 tails together, he will win. And loses otherwise. Calculate the probability that Hanif will lose the game. Wo lose kab hoga? अगर उसको तीनों हेड एंड तीनों टेल ना आए तो ही विल लूज द गेम. करेक्ट ऑर नॉट? सो नाउ लेट अस गो बैक टू द प्रोबेबिलिटी. व्हेन इज ही हैविंग 3 हेड्स एंड 3 टेल्स? ओनली 2 सिचुएशन. मीन्स 6 सिचुएशंस आर सच वेयर ही विल नॉट हैव 3 हेड्स एंड 3 टेल्स, 3 हेड्स और 3 टेल्स. सो 6 पॉसिबिलिटीज आउट ऑफ 8, पी ऑफ ए विल बी इक्वल टू 6 पॉसिबिलिटीज आउट ऑफ 8, दैट कम्स टू 2 threes are 2 fours are. Did you understand that? Out of 8 possibilities, 2 possibilities are such that he will have 3 heads or 3 tails, and remaining 6 possibilities are where his chances of losing will be high. So Hanif loses if 6 out of 8 is there. Understood or not? Next. A die is thrown twice. What is the probability that 5 will not come either time? Or 5 will come up at least once? Now again see, a die being thrown twice or 2 die thrown once ka ek hi result hai, which we just now saw in the 13th sum, 13th example wala jo maine abhi aapko dikhaya. So a die is thrown twice means one single die you are throwing two times, or you are throwing two die one time, is one and the same result. Now 5 will not come either time. So for that I'll take the result which is there on the previous page. Okay, this is the result you will get if you throw two dice once or one die twice. Now 5 will not come up either time. Aisa dikha hai na? Question is 5 will not come up either time. Either time 5 will not come up means see, 5 comes up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, because this is already considered, okay? So 11 times you will come across 5 coming up either once or twice. Baki kisi mein bhi 5 nahi aata hai. Am I right? Only in this combination the 5 will come either once or twice. Otherwise it will not come. So how many times did we count? 11 times out of 36. So your probability over here will be 11 upon 36. Did you get me? So 5 will not come up. 5 will not come up means 11 you have to subtract from 36. So kitni bar? 25. Yeah. 25 out of 36 over here. Whereas here it is 5 will come up at least once. At least once means at least ek bar. Dono bar aaye to chalega. So 5 will come up at least once or twice. Kitni bar hai? 11 times we saw. So here the answer will be 11 upon 36. Here you have to remove 11 from 36. It will be 25 upon 36. 5 will not come up. Understood? So P of A, P of B. Like that it is. Clear till there? Okay. Now we move on to the 25th question. Which of the following arguments are correct and which are not correct? Give reason. What is the first argument? If two coins are tossed simultaneously, there are three possible outcomes. Two heads, two tails, or one of each. Now here there are two coins. Earlier I showed you about three coins. Now let us see about two coins. What will it be? If there are two coins tossed once or one coin tossed twice, the possibility will be both the time head, first time head, second time tail, first time tail, second time head, and both the times tail. Kitne possibility hai? Char. If two coins are tossed once or one coin is tossed twice, these are the possibilities. Now out of that, what is mentioned in the question is, if you are going to toss two coins, there are three possibilities they are saying, two heads, two tails, or one of each. What did we get? Two heads, two tails, one of each nahi hai. You may get head and tail or tail and head. So it will be two of each, not one of each. So probability, what is given is 1/3 in your textbook, that is wrong. You will not get 1/3. Did you get it? Because actually it is going to be 1/4. Clear or not? Total 4 possibilities are there, not 3 possibility. Okay. The second situation is, if a die is thrown, there are two possible outcomes, an odd number or an even number. Therefore the probability of getting an odd number is half. This is a true statement. Why you know? Because in a die how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of that, how many odd and how many even are there? 1, 3 and 5 are odd. 2, 4 and 6 are even. So, both the cases there are 3 each. Out of how many possibilities? 6. So, 3/6 comes to half. So, this is a true statement, but this is a false statement. Clear till there? Now, we move on very quickly to the optional exercise. The first sum. Two customers, Shyam and Ekta, are visiting a particular shop in the same week. Tuesday to Saturday they are going. Each is likely to visit the shop on any day as on the other. What is the probability that both will visit the shop on the same day or consecutive day or different days? Now for this what should you do, you know? You have to prepare a table. Kya kaha gaya hai? Shyam and Ekta are moving. So we will write Shyam over here and we will write Ekta over here. and then from Tuesday to Saturday they are going, isn't it? So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So for this girl also you will have to write over here like that. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Okay? And then you prepare the table. Did you understand? This is how you prepare the table. Prepare it neatly. I am holding the camera in one hand and then with single hand I am doing it, so it might not be very neat. Okay. Chalo. Now the first column would be, here there is a line coming up. Okay, I forgot to draw it. This will be Tuesday, Tuesday, this two together. This will be Tuesday, Wednesday. Samajh aa rahi hai kaise banaya? This will be Tuesday, Thursday. This is Tuesday, Friday, Tuesday, Saturday. Understood? Tuesday with Tuesday, Tuesday with Wednesday, Tuesday with Thursday, Tuesday with Friday, Tuesday with Saturday. Now Wednesday with Tuesday. So Wednesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 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 Thursday. Samajh aa raha hai? You have to prepare like this. Same way over here. Thursday, Thursday, Tuesday, Thursday, Wednesday. Okay? Thursday, Thursday. Then here Thursday, Friday, Thursday, Saturday. Here it will be Friday, Tuesday, Friday, Wednesday, Friday, Thursday, Friday, Friday and Friday, Saturday. This will be Saturday, Tuesday, Saturday, Wednesday, Saturday, Thursday, Saturday, Friday and Saturday, Saturday. Now come back to this. After preparing this table, now what is the question mentioned? You know, Shyam and Ekta, they both are friends. They are going to shopping from Tuesday to Saturday. So there is a possibility that Shyam. So if Shyam has gone on Tuesday, then Ekta might go on Wednesday, or maybe both of them together might land in the shop on Tuesdays only, isn't it? So this is how the table has been prepared. Now the question asked is, you have to find the probability what that they are going to visit the shop on the same day. First of all, how many possibilities are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 into 5, how many combinations will be there? 25 possibilities are there. Barabar. So now for the first case, same day. Same day means both of them are going on Tuesdays or Wednesdays or Thursdays or Fridays or Saturday. Kitni baar hai? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times they are going. There is a possibility that they may visit on the same day. So 5 out of 25 comes to 1 by 5. Did you understand? You will write probability A, P of A is equal to, they are visiting the shop on the same time, same day upon total number of days. So 5 upon 25. Second situation given is, they are visiting consecutive days. Consecutive means one after the other. One after the other ka matlab kya hua? Tuesday, Wednesday. Okay? And then Wednesday, Thursday. Thursday, Friday. Friday, Saturday. 1, 2, 3, 4 ho gaya. Okay. Uske baad kaun sa aayega? You have Wednesday, Thursday. Friday, Thursday, Friday. And Friday, Saturday. These three also will be there. So how many did we count earlier? 1, 2, 3, 4. And here 5, 6, 7. Then again, is there any other cases where you have one after the other? Just check it out. If not, then it will be 7 upon 25. Is that point clear? 7 out of 25. You'll have to check whether it is right or wrong, but this is how you have to search it. Is that point clear? One after the other. Then next is different days. Different days means what? First 5 days were same days, no? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 were same days, common days. And 7 days were one after the other. So 5 and 7, 12 days if you remove out of 25 days. Baki ke 13 din, they are going on different days. Different days means if one fellow, Shyama goes on Tuesday, then Ekta is going on Thursday. So Tuesday and Thursday is not one after the other day, or it's not the same day. So different days ho gaya. Clear? But Tuesday, Wednesday ho gaya, it is one after the other. Did you understand what I am trying to say? So for the second case, if it is 7, First case 5 we already considered, so total 12 days if you remove out of 25, remaining is 13 days out of 25. Clear with the sum? Okay. Next you are having, a die is numbered in such a way that its faces are showing 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 6. And it is thrown 2 times. And the total scores in 2 throws is noted. Complete the following table which will give a few values of the following total score on the 2 throws. So this is how the table is there. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 6. So here also 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 6. Now the sum is to be, sum is written down over here. See, 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 3, 4, 1 plus 3, 4, 1 plus 6, 7. Then 2 plus 1, 3, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 3, 5, 2 plus 3, 5, 2 plus 6, 8. अब ये बाकी जगह आपको फिल अप करना है. सो हाउ विल यू फिल इट अप? 2 प्लस 1, सो हियर इट विल बी 3. देन 2 प्लस 2, 4. 2 प्लस 2, 4. 2 प्लस 3, 5. 2 प्लस 3, 5. एंड 2 प्लस 6, 8. देन 3 प्लस 1, 4. 3 प्लस 2, 5. 3 प्लस 2, 5. 3 प्लस 3, 6. 3 प्लस 3, 6. 3 प्लस 6, 9. नाउ दिस इज ऑल्सो 3. So it will be the same number only because here the numbers are same. So it will be 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 9. And now this addition you have to check. 2 plus 1, 3 and 3, 6. No, sorry. 6 plus 1, 7. 6 plus 2, 8. 6 plus 2, 8. 6 plus 3, 9. 6 plus 3, 9. 6 plus 6, 12. Okay, you put addition table tayar. What is the probability that the score is even? Okay. How many times did you get first of all? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and here also 6. So 36 possibilities you have got. Out of these 36 possibilities, how many times are you getting an even total? Even total you are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18 times you are getting out of 36, so it will be half. Clear? How many times are you getting 6? 6 total you will get it 1, 2, 3, 4 times you are getting. So 4 out of 36. At least 6 means 6 or greater than that. 6 or greater than that, how much is there? 1, 2, 3, 4 is already there. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 times you are getting greater than 6. No, 13, then here also it is there, no? 14, 15. Count it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 times. So 15 times you are getting a number 6 or greater than 6. So 15 out of 36. Did you get me? That is how you work out this sum. Next, a bag contains 12 balls, sorry, 5 red balls and some blue balls. We don't know how many blue balls. Okay. If the probability of drawing a blue ball is double that of red ball, find the number of blue balls in the bag. So this is an equation type of sum. Very important. A bag is containing how many balls? 5 red balls are there. And the number of blue balls we don't know. So let it be x. Okay. There are 5 red balls. Number of blue balls is x. So total number of balls will be how much? Total number will be 5 plus x. Correct? If the probability of drawing a blue ball. Now probability of drawing a blue ball will be equal to what? The number of blue ball upon total number of balls. Aisa hi hoga na? Number of blue ball we don't know. So x. Total number of balls is 5 plus x. This probability is given to you double that of red ball. Okay. First of all, this is probability of blue ball. Now, probability of red ball kya hoga? Red ball will be 5 upon 5 plus x. Why? Because there are 5 red balls and total number of balls is 5 plus x. So, this is probability of blue. This is probability of red. Now, what is the relation between the two given to you? This is the probabilities which you have got. But what is the relation between them? The statement says blue balls probability is double red. Blue balls probability is double red. Now both the denominators are same, so they get cancelled out. So you will have x is equal to 2 times 5, that is 10. Understood? So number of blue balls kitne hain? 10. Clear about this sum? Okay. Now we take up the next sum. A similar one. A box is containing 12 balls, out of which x are black. If one is drawn from the box, what is the probability that it will be a black ball? Okay. Box is containing 12 balls. So here the statement will be total balls this time is given to you 12. Okay, total number of balls. And black we don't know how many, so it is x they are saying. If one ball you are going to draw out, then the probability of black will be equal to number of black balls upon total number. This will be the probability of the black ball which is going to come out. कोई भी एक बॉल निकाल रहे तो वो ब्लैक होने के चांसेस क्या है? टोटल नंबर ऑफ ब्लैक बॉल्स अपॉन 12. क्लियर? नाउ इफ 6 मोर बॉल्स आर पुट इन द बॉक्स, सो टोटल नंबर ऑफ बॉल्स कितने हो जाएंगे? टोटल नंबर ऑफ बॉल्स नाउ विल बिकम 12 प्लस कितने? 6 कम्स टू 18 बॉल्स. देन द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ब्लैक बॉल नाउ इज डबल दैट बिफोर. तो ब्लैक बॉल इज नॉट इंक्रीजिंग. नो द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ इफ 6 मोर ब्लैक बॉल्स आर पुट इनटू द बॉक्स, सॉरी 6 मोर ब्लैक बॉल्स, सो 12 विल बी एडेड टू 6, सो 18 विल बी टोटल नंबर ऑफ बॉल्स एंड नंबर ऑफ ब्लैक बॉल्स विल बिकम हाउ मच? x प्लस 6, क्योंकि ब्लैक बढ़ाया गया है. नाउ द प्रोबेबिलिटी विल बी हाउ मच? दिस टाइम वील टेक इट एज पी बी डैश. ओके, दिस इज द न्यू सेट. सो प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस बॉल will become x plus 6 upon 18. Now this is the new probability, this is the previous probability. They are saying that the new probability is double the previous one. Previous one kitna tha? X upon 12. Okay, so now what should you do? X plus 6 is to be multiplied by 12. Okay, and this 18 will be multiplied by 2x. So total 18 2s are 36 and here it is 12. So can I write like this? X plus 6 is equal to 3x likh sakti hun, because 18 2s are 36 and 36 is 12 3s are. So finally your 2x will be equal to 6, so x will be equal to 3. Yani hamara jo black ball ki sankhya thi wo kitni thi pehle? 3. Understood the full sum now? Okay, this is the full sums view. I took it up. Correct? Chalo. Now we move on to the last sum. With that, your chapter is over. What is the last sum telling you? A jar is containing 24 marbles. Some are green and some are blue. If the marble drawn at random from the jar, the probability that is green is 2 by 3. Find the number of blue balls in the jar. We don't know how many balls are there. So we will say let the number of green be x and blue be y. Okay, total number kitne hain? 24. That means x plus y is 24. If the marble drawn out from the jar, probability of green is 2 by 3 given. Okay, so actually probability of green will be how much according to this particular case? It will be x upon x plus y, yani x upon 24. Will be equal to 2 by 3 which is given to you. Do you understand that? According to the statement, probability of green will be x upon x plus y. That is x upon 24. And that answer is given to you 2/3. So x upon 24 is 2/3 given. So from this much part, can I find out x value? X will be 24 into 2/3 comes to 16. 3 8s are 24, 8 2s are 16. So if x is 16, what will be y, children? Because 24 is total, so y will be 8. Understood? So you got the number of blue balls in the jar. There are 8 blue balls. With this, your chapter is over. Please complete all the sums in your notebook. Is that point clear or not, children?